Your monthly subscription box from postflybox.com includes all the materials needed to tie a dozen flies, along with some extra goodies. The hoof fly is a durable and effective saltwater fly pattern that imitates a wide range of bait fish, including silversides, peanut bunker, and bay anchovies, or rainfish. It works well for striped bass, bluefish, and false albacore. To start, pick up one of the size 8 heavy-duty short shank hooks and get it firmly secured in the jaws of your tying vise. For thread, load a bobbin with a spool of white Unithread. Get the thread started on the hook shank, leaving a small space behind the eye, and take 10 or so wraps rearward before snipping off the excess tag. Tease up an inch square segment of the white craft fur and snip it free, down close to the backing. Strip out the lower shorter fibers from the butt ends, then measure to form a body that's 3 to 4 hook lengths long. Using the back edge of the hook eye as a guide for your scissors, snip the excess butt ends off square. Place the clump back down on top of the hook shank and give your bobbin a counterclockwise spin so the first wrap of tying thread jumps slightly rearward to catch the butts. While maintaining your pinch on the clump, take a few tight thread wraps to anchor it. Then, work the material around the hook shank. Continue taking thread wraps to secure the craft fur around the hook shank. Then, take additional wraps to cover the butt ends and smooth out the tie-down area. Pull a small clump of gray SST dubbing from the packet and fold it in half, then snip the loop. Fold it in half again and snip that loop. Pull out any extra long errant fibers so you're left with a clump that looks something like this. Place the clump on top of the hook shank so its tips extend about a third of the way down the craft fur. Once again, use the back edge of the hook eye as a guide for your scissors and snip the excess butt ends off square. Here too, spin your bobbin counterclockwise and take tight wraps of tying thread to anchor the material, but only to the top of the hook shank, not spread around it. Pull a somewhat smaller clump of UV blue angel hair free from the packet and find its midpoint. Place the midpoint of the clump above your tying thread and take a wrap to secure it, then pull the forward pointing half back and take thread wraps to pin it back. Trim off any wayward or excessively long fibers. Flip the fly over to give you easier access to the underside of the hook. Take a pinch of the pink SST dubbing from the packet and find its midpoint. Once again, place the midpoint above your tying thread and repeat the same tie-in procedure as you did with the angel hair. Trim the pink fibers off so they extend just past the bend of the hook. Tease and trim the fibers into a nice flat bait fish shape. Take a few more thread wraps behind the hook eye, then reach for your whip finish tool and use it to do a 3 or 4 turn whip finish, seat the knot well, and snip your tying thread free. Squeeze out an ample drop of your favorite flexible adhesive, here UV Cure resin. Using a bodkin, scoop up a good-sized drop and apply it to both sides of the fly, from the hook eye back to about the barb. Then, let the adhesive dry or give it a shot of UV light to cure it. Place a small drop of the same adhesive behind the hook eye, then retrieve a single 3D eye from the sheet. Place the eye on top of the adhesive. Here, I'm giving it a shot of UV light to cure the resin. You can then flip the fly over and repeat the same procedure on the far side, doing your best to align the second eye with the first. A light skim of adhesive over the front edges of the eyes will ensure they're permanently affixed. And that's the hoof fly. The synthetic fibers are generally more durable than comparable natural hairs, yet no less effective.